introduce your first name. And there will be a clock here. So the next talk is about good randomness tests by Zhuangzi Zhu, Yuan Ma, Jiangqiang Lin, Jia Zhuang, and Jiwu Ying, and Zhu will give the talk, please.
Hello, everyone. I'm a student, and I'm honored to be here to address you. And the title of my paper is More Powerful and Reliable Second Level Statistical Randomness Test for NIST Special Publication 800-22. I do this work with the help of my teacher, Ningning Xiaohua, and Ting Yu. The talk will be divided into the three parts: background, context, and contributions. As we all know, RNG play an important role in many cryptographic applications, and the statistical test are one employed the statistical quality of RNG output, which is a kind of black box test, since we know nothing about generator. And this special publication 800-22 test suite is one of the most common new statistical test suites. Our work is about it. When we start a statistical test, first we have to make a null hypothesis, and then we analyze the data under the null hypothesis, and finally we draw a conclusion to reject or accept the null hypothesis. And for this test suite, the null hypothesis is the RNG outputs are good randomness, and there are 15 test animals to verify the hypothesis from different aspects. The whole sequence is divided into 10 sequence blocks, and then we compute the statistic and the p-value for each sequence block in each test error. And we compare the value in the significance level alpha. If p-value is larger or equal to alpha, this block passes the test. If not, and the opposite conclusion. And then I will give introduction to the whole test procedure. First, the whole sequence is divided into 10 sequence blocks. Here I set 10 as 1,000. And then we choose the test error and compute 1,000 p-values and do the first level test and second level test. And the first level test checks the pass rate of the 1,000 blocks. And the second level test checks the uniformity of the 1,000 key values by computing the new key value called PT. And if PT is less than 1,000, the second level test fails. And if anyone fails, the RNG is considered no good. Here I should add that each test error has its own test statistics, and according to their statistics distribution, the 15 test errors are divided into two tests: the binomial distribution this test and the t-square distribution this test. Our work is about the binomial distribution this test, and here I'll talk about our contribution. We found that the p-value of the binomial based test are unqualified for second level test, although it is proper to be used for the first level test. And so we propose a new metric p-value for second level test to replace the original p-value. And then we prove that using q-value for second level test increases the test coverage. And finally we do experiments to confirm our conclusion. And I'll show you why q-value is unqualified. statistic value C of final this test based on standard norm distribution. So P value of D is showing the figure and compute use the absolute value of D. And the problem comes from the absolute value. To better understand this problem, I choose the logical relationship between these postics. And the C1, P value is an uniform distribution from 0 to 1. C2, absolute value of D of this half normal distribution. And C3, D is a standard normal distribution. C4, testing sequence has good randomness. That is our null hypothesis. We can see that stage 1 and 2 are equal. And for statistical tests, we can think that stage 3 and 4 are equal. But stage 2 and 3 are not equal. This is the problem. Here I'll give an example to show how this problem affects tests. To construct a various sequence which can pass a NIST test in the following steps. First, generate a random base sequence which can pass the test suite. For example, we use the BBS generator, which is acknowledged as a full GRD. And second, if for each block, if the number of zeros is more than that of ones, we perform a feedback knot on this sequence block. Otherwise, we keep the block unchanged. The process sequence is significantly first, as the number of 1 is larger than that of 0 in all blocks. However, the process sequence still has a very high probability to pass the test suite. If 0 and 1 have equal rules in the validation of randomness for each block. And this table is a test report of the original BBS output. And we can see that all the PP are greater than 1,000. So the another improvement is about actual distribution. As we all know, when n is infinite, p-values of a uniform distribution. But in fact, n is limited, so the actual distribution of p-values is discrete. And I'll illustrate this. All the figures following are from frequency test. And you can see the orange line is the uniform distribution, and the dashed line with no symbol is the distribution, is the actual distribution of p-values. And the other line with symbol is experiment data. You can see there is this difference between the actual distribution of p-values and the uniform distribution. And q-value also have actual distribution. In this figure, the solid line is represents the distribution, actual distribution of Q value, and the dashed line represents the actual distribution of P value. We can see the Q value line is closer to the uniform distribution. To better see the difference, I just show the cumulative function between Q value and P value with the parameter more than equal to 200, which means a block only consists of 200 bits. So we can see clearly that the Q value is smoother, is more smoother. And then some experiments. We do the Q-value based test on the following charges, and the experiment test, and the result, just support our conclusion. And the more details about the experiment in the paper, and that's given this. That is the conclusion. The standard law in p-value is that now has and for the q-value is one to six. We prove the rationality of q-value. And we prove q-value increase the test capability. And we test the charges also to confirm our discovery. That's all, thank you.
Okay. So, are there any questions? I have one question myself. So, as I understand you, in the beginning you had this artificial distribution that tricks the NIST suite. And now you have a better test that is not tricked by it. But could it be that there's some other artificial distribution, like with different ideas, that would actually then, that would be biased and pass the Q value-based test? So you have a distribution that passes the p-value test, but is biased.
Yes.
Can it be that there's another distribution, a different one, that is biased and passes your new test, the cube value based test?
Okay, I know what you mean. In fact, there exists first sequence can pass the p-value two second level test. For reason, the C2 and 3 are not equal. So there exists some bias sequence. But when you use the Q value 1, all the states are equal. So if it is biased, so it couldn't pass the Q value second level.
Okay, thank you. Any other questions? Then let's thank the speaker again. And that was the end of this session. So everyone have a nice evening.